Hello everyone, this is Chris from Recombo, and if I sound a little bit tired or out of it, that's because I got up at just before 4 this morning to come to Munich for the launch of the Huawei Mate 9, this beast that I'm holding in my left hand. It's a 5.9-inch phablet, rocking premium specs, and also a premium price, €699, which in the UK will probably mean about £2,000 thanks to Brexit. Cheers, guys. And on my right hand, I got the OnePlus 3, which also packs premium specs and is a massive phone, but also has a much, much slender price. It's only £329 in the UK. So is the Mate 9 really worth that extra bump in cost? Well, in terms of actual design, let's start at the basics. As you can see, they're both more or less the same size, about the same width and everything as well. And if we stack them up one on top of the other, get a nice little phone sandwich on the go. You can see they're both pretty slender as well, considering that massive size. They both rock a gorgeous metallic frame as well, which is lovely. You can pick up the Mate 9 in a couple of different choices, silver and white or dark grey, whereas the OnePlus 3, you're stuck with the bog standard silver, but it still looks lovely. It's gone a bit mental as well, because I left the screen on. Neither phone is waterproof, unfortunately, but they've both got a nice little heft to them, and they're both suitably rugged. You can really smack them about if you want to, and they seem to be quite scratch resistant, quite hardy in general, which is nice. In terms of media and all the rest, you get a gorgeous 5.9-inch screen on the Mate 9. It's absolutely lovely. Full HD, so nice and crisp. Not quite the quad HD of some of its rivals like the Note 7. Well, the Note 7 before it died a fiery death. But still perfectly sharp for all of your needs, basically. You'll have to squint really, really hard to see any kind of individual pixel there. It's also nice and vibrant as well, as you can see. And you can go into the menu, which we'll do now, display menu, and have a play around with all kinds of different stuff. So you can get the color temperature just the way you like it. There's a full-on eye comfort mode, which is basically a blue filter mode. So that makes it nice and warm and easy on the eye when you're using it at night. So there's a few different customization options there. And as you can see, viewing angles are fantastic. And yeah, contrast levels are great as well. Nice dark blacks and everything. The OnePlus 3, you get a 5.5-inch. Again, it's a full HD screen. So again, nice and sharp, technically sharper than the Mate 9. So images look absolutely gorgeous. It's an AMOLED screen. So again, nice vibrant colors. And if you go into the settings menu, you can once again fiddle around with some of the settings. So there you go, you see you can change the color balance, make it cold or warm. And you've got full adaptive brightness and all the rest of it. And of course the night mode, the same as the Huawei, but you can't actually schedule the night mode on the OnePlus, unfortunately. But still lots of customization, and once again, great viewing angles and top brightness. It's easily a match for the Mate 9. In terms of the processing power, the OnePlus 3 is still incredibly powerful considering the price. Snapdragon 820 with 6 gigs of RAM, which means it's super nippy. The Mate 9 packs in Huawei's latest Kirin 960, which is ridiculously powerful. This thing should easily last a 2-year contract. Super powered and very, very strong GPU built in as well, so it should be great for your 3D gaming and all the rest of it. But both handsets, both nippy. If you try to tap in some of the apps, as you can see, they load up pretty much instantly. The Mate 9 is slightly nippier, as you can see. There's a bit more of a delay on the OnePlus, but on the whole, very, very impressive indeed. If we load up the camera at the same time, as you can see, there's not much of a difference there at all. In terms of the actual UI and everything, so you get Android Marshmallow at the moment on the OnePlus 3 with a few little tweaks from OnePlus. I believe it's called the Oxygen OS. So for instance, you've got your little shelf shortcut and all the rest on there, and some extra customization options. Whereas on the Mate 9, it is the latest Android Nougat, and it's running Huawei's Emotion UI on top of it, Emotion UI 5.0. If you just dive into the about, as you can see there. So this adds a few extra features that we've been missing in the past, such an apps tray, which you already get on the OnePlus 3. I haven't got it set up just yet, but you can actually tidy away all of your apps now, which is lovely, and make it a nice clean experience. There's also a very strong emphasis on blue. As you see, there's a lot of the apps are blue, a lot of the icons are blue, and all the rest of it as well. So if you like blue, good. If you don't, whoops. Maybe install a different launcher on it, I guess. But yeah, but you've got all the latest Android features on there as well. But of course, the OnePlus 3 should hopefully receive an upgrade to full Nougat at some point. As for battery tech, you get a decent bit of battery life from the OnePlus 3. It has degraded a little bit recently. It used to be a full day and a half quite easily. Now we just about get a day out of it. But we have been absolutely hammering this beast, to be honest, for several months now, so it's not a real surprise. With dash charging, charge it up in just over an hour to full capacity. Huawei packs in a 4,000 milliamp cell into the Mate 9. We haven't had a chance to fully test it yet, but they do promise up to 2 days of battery life, even with heavy usage. And you do get a supercharged charger in the box, which again is supposed to charge it up super, super fast in like an hour or so. So it should be a rival for dash charge. Again, we'll do a full comparison test and everything. Which brings us nicely onto the cameras. So on the OnePlus 3, let's start with that. You get a 16 megapixel rear camera. As you can see, just a single lens there and a single LED flash. And while it isn't exactly a stunning camera, it perfectly does the job nicely. It's super, super fast. The autofocus is great. You get image stabilization built in, and you can shoot up to 4K video on it as well. Unfortunately, the video, we found some issues in the past with some spots, the audio in particular. Sometimes it's a bit stuttery, a bit echoey, which is a shame. But you do get a few little bonus features as well. You've got a full manual mode, which is nice, and you can shoot in panorama. But it's generally quite a sort of a pared down, quite a simple snapper. You do get HDR mode and the rest, but besides that, not much else. If we dodge onto the Mate 9's camera, this is definitely a step up in terms of optics. So you get a dual camera second generation Leica lens. So Huawei's basically cooperating with the optics firm Leica to generate these new camera experiences for mobile phones, which is lovely. So you get a 12 megapixel RGB color lens and a 20 megapixel monochrome lens. And they basically work together in order to create some really nice detailed true to life photos. So if we just take a couple of quick snaps here, as you can see, it's super, super fast again, just like the OnePlus 3. You can actually hold that down and get ridiculous numbers of photos being rattled off. You also get full manual modes with full manual controls. If I can just flick it across, there we go. So that gives you all the extra sort of expert stuff you can fiddle with, ISO levels, white balance and all the rest of it, if you so desire. Or you can just tuck those away and rely on the auto mode. Huawei has also packed in tons of bonus camera modes. If we just flick this across, as you can see, you've got your standard monochrome and filters and all the rest of it. You've got HDR mode, just like the OnePlus. Video, you can once again shoot up to 4K. And Huawei has invented a new compression technique, apparently, which means that your 4K videos won't take up all of the storage space on your phone, which is nice. Night shot modes, light painting, of course, which Huawei is infamous for now, and all the rest of it. So you get a few bonus modes on the Huawei, which you don't get on the OnePlus. And hopefully the general camera performance should be top notch as well. As for storage as well, of course, before I forget that, both phones come with 64 gigs of storage. And while you can't expand the storage on the OnePlus 3, there's no microSD memory card slot. There is microSD in the Mate 9, so you can expand by a further 256, I believe it is. So plenty of space for all of your photos and media. So that in a nutshell is the Mate 9 versus the OnePlus 3. So if you don't have the €699 for the Mate 9, maybe try the £329 OnePlus 3 instead. Thanks for watching, everyone, and stay tuned for more Mate 9 loveliness. Woo!